We are now going to try to understand a very important concept about circles. Look at this circle divided into two equal parts. How do we find the area of this colored part? Let's assume that the radius of this circle is r units. You are familiar with the area of a circle, and we can see that it covers half the circle. So the area will be half multiplied by pi r squared. This is the area of this circle, and we multiply it by half to find the area of this colored part. Now look at this circle, which is divided into four equal parts. What will be the area of this colored part? It will be 1 by 4 multiplied by pi r squared. Since the area of the circle is split into four equal parts, we multiply it by 1 by 4. Let's look at another part of the circle. This part. What will be the area of the colored region in this case? Without any information, we cannot find the formula for the area of this part. More importantly, what we are trying to find is the part of the area of a circle. These colored regions are called sectors. You may think of a sector as a pizza slice. A sector is covered by two radii and an arc. In the first case, these are the two radii and this is the arc. In the second case, these two are the radii and this is the arc. And in the third case, the sector is covered by these two radii and this arc. Coming back to the question, how do we find the area of the sector? The area of a sector is proportional to the angle that the arc subtends at the center. It is called the sector angle. In the first case, the sector angle is 180 degrees. Hence, the area of the sector will be 180 by 360 multiplied by pi r squared. Out of the total 360 degrees, these two radii have 180 degrees between them. This value is the same as this value as the ratio equals half. Similarly, since the sector angle is 90 degrees in the second case, the area of this sector will be 90 by 360 multiplied by pi r squared, which equals this. So if this angle is 30 degrees, then the area of the sector will be 30 by 360 multiplied by pi r squared. This part is the area of the circle, and this part tells us how much of the circle is covered. To generalize the formula for a sector, we can say that if the sector angle is theta, then the area of a sector will be theta by 360 multiplied by pi r squared.